Good morning, students. So starting with the new topic. So this chapter is air and noise pollution. We already see or teach these air pollution, right? So next is the noise pollution. What is the exactly noise pollution? What are its effect on environment or humans or animals, etc. Right, and what are the proper solutions of this noise pollution, right? So what are the procedures and what are the measurements and what are the instrument which is used to measure this noise pollution, right? So first of all, the understanding that what is the noise pollution, right? So sound that is unwanted or disrupts one's quality of life is called as a noise. So when there is a lot of noise in the environment, so basically it terms as a noise pollution. So sounds becomes undesirable when it disturbs the normal activities such as working, sleeping, or during a conversation. Right. So it is a underrated environmental problem because of the fact that we can't see, smell, or taste it. So World Health Organization, WHO, stated that the noise must be recognized as a major threat to the human well-being. Right? Next is how to measure the noise. Right? So a decibel is a standard for the measurement of noise. So there are different criteria for different types of noise. So for example, whisper is of 20 decibel. Noise in the quiet office is 40 decibel. Normal conversation noise is 60 dB means decibel, and 80 decibel is the level at which the sounds become physically painful and can be termed as noise. So 20, 40, 60 is normal rate of or normal measurement of noise. If these voice are increasing above 60 or 70 decibels, so it becomes physically painful, right? So that it is termed as a noise. So there are decibel meters, as you can see in this figure. The following, this photo shows the different kinds of decibel meters, right? With the use of this instrument, we usually measures the noise, right? So what are the sources of noise pollution? So there are main sources of noise pollution is household sources, social events, commercial and industrial activities, transportation, right? So talking about the household sources, so gadgets like a food mixer, grinder, vacuum cleaner, washing machine, and dryer, cooler, air conditioners, this all can be very noisy and injurious to health. So others include that loudspeakers of the sound system and TVs and iPods and earphones. This all causes noise pollution, right? So another example may be your neighbor's dog barking all the night, every day, at every shadow it sees, the disturbing everyone else in the apartment. So it defines as a noise pollution, right? So these all are the household sources, which means all the house activities or the instrument used in our regular life, or we extremely use the maximum noise, right? So household sources, like I already explained, that this gadgets, right, loudspeakers, TV, high volume of TVs, right, neighbor's dog, etc. This all are the household sources. Next is the social events. So places of worship, discos, gigs, parties, and other social events also create a lot of noise for the people living in that area. So in many market area, people sell with the loudspeakers, others shout out offers and try to get customers to buy their goods. So because of their selling strategies, we also disturb the living people in that area. So it is important to note that where these events are not often, they can be called nuisance rather than the noise pollution, right? So these all are the social events. Next is commercial and industrial activities. So printing presses, manufacturing industries, construction sites contribute the noise pollution in the large cities. So in many industries, it is required that the people always wear earplugs to minimize their exposure to the heavy noise. So people who work with the noisy equipments are required to wear noise-proof gadgets so that their ears cannot be damaged due to this loud noise or any other instruments which creates a lot of noise during manufacturing, right? So commercial and industrial activities includes basically printing press and manufacturing industries and construction sites, right? So these all are the our basic need for the requirements of daily materials, right? Which is manufacturing in that big industries, manufacturing industries, right? So we cannot stop the manufacturing products or construction sites to make noise so that we can use alternate options such as use the noise proof gadgets or generally we use earplugs to minimize the exposure to the heavy noise, right? So these are the alternatives how we can save human beings from the noise pollution. Next is the transportation. So aeroplanes flying over the houses close to the busy airports, right? Over the ground and underground trains, vehicles on the road, these are constantly making lot of noises. So this all are the basic main source of transportation and main sources of noise pollution. So what are the effects of noise pollution? So noise pollution makes men more irritable. The effect of noise pollution is multifaceted and interrelated. So the effect of noise pollution on human beings, animals, and properties are as follows. So starting with the different types of effects due to noise pollution is, first of all, hearing impairment. It decreases the efficiency of a man, lack of concentration, abortion is caused, pupil dilation, mental illness, it causes heart attack, digestive problem, temporary or permanent deafness, aggressive behavior, an effect on vegetation, poor quality of crops, effect on animal, effect on the properties, sleep interference, and speech interference. So these all are basically the effect of noise pollution, right? And this makes a man, this makes a person more irritable because of this constantly living in the noisy environment, right? So these are the effect of noise pollution, right? So we stop our lecture here. If you have any confusion about the measurement of noise and the sources of the noise pollution and the effect of noise pollution, so you can contact me.